On the floor, Truck Bryant is Bob Huggins' point guard. Kevin Jones, a double-double waiting to happen. And it's really a pretty deep team. Watch for Jones to come up with a big night if West Virginia plays well. For Portland, the Pilots have good size. Smelders and Knutson, they go 6'10 and 6'9. Campbell, Rivio, and Needham are all seniors. The Pilots are no accident. They are experienced, they are deep, and they are talented. Revenue, their head coach, says they have been waiting for this moment for a long, long time to step right into the spotlight. And stepping into our spotlight right now is our man, Andy Katz.
Well, Bob Huggins was here early watching that previous game, and I asked him, who's the pressure on? He said, look, it's on them. It's on us. There's no question about it. Portland basically playing with house money here. No pressure on them. Very relaxed. As for Eric Revenue, the Portland head coach, he said, well, I don't know about that. But he says, if we can get a lead up eight or something like that, then he thinks the pressure may end up being on West Virginia.
All right, so a lot of talk about pressure whenever you get to a championship game at the end of a tournament like this, in which of the eight teams, four were ranked in the top 25. Eric Revenue, big guy himself at 6'8", in his fourth season as the Portland head coach. He was the West Coast Conference Coach of the Year last season. There are many who believe they're going to unseat Gonzaga as champions of that conference. We'll find out. He may be on the verge of busting into the top 25. The Pilots in the white, a scramble for the opening tip, and Butler comes away with it, and West Virginia will have their first crack at it. Mountaineers number eight in the country. This is the first meeting ever between the two schools.
West Virginia run a lot of sets to get the ball to their shooters. Missoula off the mark.
Mitchell on high and a foul after the miss in the opening seconds here. And Portland, a team, as you mentioned, it can absolutely shoot the lights out against UCLA, embarrassing the Bruins on Thanksgiving. They hit 11 out of 19. And if they get hot early, they usually don't stop hitting.
Well, they're a pick-your-poison team, as we talked about over the course of the weekend. If you extend to their shooters, they have capable big men down low that can go to work. If you collapse to the bigs, they pass the ball well, they recognize the openings, and they find the shooters on the perimeter.
Knutson with the foul is first. Now they trap deep in the corner right in front of the bench. Out with it, Mitchell, the pull-up pop. That is short. Robin Smelders, the 6'10 senior, cradling that rebound. He can take up a lot of space there. Rivio trying to give it off, knocked away from him. Here comes Bryant, Truck Bryant, pushing the tempo and fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot two. Terrific finish in the game right in front of us between Clemson and Butler. Went down to the final seconds, and the Clemson Tigers pulled it out, knocking off the number 10 team in the country. T.J. Campbell with the foul, number one. And Bryant at the line, a 71% foul shooter in his career.
Going back to my original point, West Virginia runs sets to get the ball in the hands of their best players. They don't just run offense to run offense. And they exploit, they expose particular matchups and run sets based on getting the ball in position to where they feel they have a competitive advantage, whether it's loading the ball up in the pivot, whether it's taking someone off the bounce.
Campbell went for the alley-oop on Smelders, but knocked out of bounds by West Virginia. So Smelders the inbound. Here's the man it all runs through. T.J. Campbell makes them go at 23 in their upset win of Minnesota. Off the inbounds, a whistle before the shot. The 19:04 remaining here in the first half, and the foul goes against Portland, and Niedermeyer is first.
Seen some multiple looks here early by the Pilots, Dave. Some man-to-man. We saw some zone defense. We saw the trap in the corner as well, trying to keep West Virginia off balance or out of rhythm offensively.
The West Virginia has really earned about 9 or 10 days off. Another quick whistle here. Foul against the Mountaineers. They're going to get about 9 days off after this. This is their fourth game this week. Started with a victory against the Citadel on Tuesday night. Then wins here in Anaheim against Long Beach State and Texas A&M. Wellington Smith with the foul for West Virginia. Opening moments of the championship game of the 76 Classic. Entry pass for Knutson. He banks it in.
Good look, delivery. into the basket area.
It's a well-coached team. They will turn it over. They're not necessarily just a half-court offense. They like to get out and run when they can.
Well, because they play at higher speeds and they're very aggressive in their mindset and approach, there will be games where they turn the ball over, but they get it back in other ways. They offset or neutralize that by shooting the ball with accuracy from distance, by getting themselves to the foul line, and those open court opportunities help as well. Here's the zone defense. Again, multiple looks, similar to a pitcher, keeping a hitter off balance in baseball, the curve, the slider, setting up a fastball.
Chuck Bryant, off target. Luke Sikma with the rebound.
Does a great job there on the rebound of squeezing the basketball. Good feed, Schmelder's inside, Campbell with the delivery. Again, excellent angles on their post feeds. That's worked on in practice, that's drilled. Well-schooled team here, Eric Reveno. Great experiences.
Off to a 5-0 start. These are very heady times for a program on the move. Here's Wellington Smith. He'll knock it down, a three-pointer.
Smith coming off the down screen for the catch and shoot in rhythm. Eric Reveno played at Stanford for 2 years under Tom Davis before Davis moved on to Iowa, and Mike Montgomery took over the program, played 2 years for Mike Montgomery, worked under Mike Montgomery as an assistant coach. Some excellent mentors and pedigree in his background.
Fabio off the bump and off the window as well. He then asked for the foul, which was not forthcoming, but Nick Rybio, first all-team West Coast Conference last year.
And 6'5", Dave. You can see over the top of defenders. He helps on the boards.
His brother was a big star at Gonzaga. His father played at Portland. Mitchell. That won't fall for him, but a second effort on the long rebound. Here's Deshaun Butler. In and out for him. And a rebound comes free to Jones. So third chance for the Mountaineers. Bryant on the baseline in heavy traffic. They're going to get another opportunity. That one off of Portland. And here comes Devin Ebanks, the 6'9 sophomore. He took that recent leave of absence to attend to a personal matter. Missed the first three games. Bob Huggins said, I wasn't really concerned about what he would do in the game. It was stamina, because he had missed so much playing time. That's what concerned me. But he played 29 minutes and had 14-9 in his first game.
Looked rather comfortable, considering the fact he was coming off the bench and had missed some action.
They hit a little jump shot from the corner. Very first time he touched it, he was off to the races.
Portland now has trapped that coffin corner twice out of their zone defense.
Butler off the fake, jumps. A lot of iron and it rolls off. And now a fight for the rebound. The tie up here, the possession arrow will send it the opposite direction. 16-18 remaining here in the first half. Portland ball. Portland, a school of about 3,000 undergrads. 5-0 right now under Eric Reveno, including the Thanksgiving night stuffing of UCLA, a 27-point blowout. UCLA lost every game of this 76 Classic. They went 0-3. Lost to Long Beach State in the seventh-place game earlier today. Knutson up top, looking for Stoll to make a cut. He's a great three-point shooter. It's going to be a holding foul. That'll go against Deshaun Butler, even though he hit the deck. His first.
They're keeping West Virginia off balance. They don't feel they can come in and just man up the Mountaineers, but by alternating, giving some zones, some man, trapping on different areas of the floor, well-devised traps along the sidelines and end lines, which act as extra defenders.
Sikma, son of Jack, throws it away. And Johnny West, son of Jerry, picked it up. Jerry West is here tonight watching his boy, who, by the way, can shoot it a little bit, as if you couldn't guess. And that's West. Off to Bryant, who will set it up now for Bob Huggins. Kevin Jones, here's Ebanks. West looking for a cutter. Deshaun Butler is averaging about 16 points per game. The pull-up by Ebanks. That's the shot that he hit the other day, first time he touched it.
Contested shot. Pilots trying to get a hand up on all shooters. Been successful to this point in the game.
Sikma lost his dribble. Rivio, another guy who the offense runs through for the Pilots. Slicing in, difficult angle using that backboard.
Found some daylight, a crack in the West Virginia defense, and took the body hit and still finished off the window.
Here's Jones lifting a long one. That's short from three-point land. Got a scramble for the rebound. West Virginia getting a lot of second and third chances, although they're not cashing in. West will let fly and banks it off the glass for two. Johnny West, junior out of Memphis, at 11 in their first round victory over Long Beach State. He nailed three threes.
Well, good release there. His father would be proud of that picture. Perfect technique off the middle three fingers.
Livio can't follow that up. Bryant quickly to the baseline. Jones spins underneath and, in fact, way too far. And he stood on that line.
You know, Jerry West, Hall of Famer, outstanding player at West Virginia, great years with the Lakers, and of course, had success as a general manager and president. Considered one of the great minds in the history of basketball in terms of the NBA and evaluating talent, and making trades, hiring of coaches.
Sikma held in the paint. He's fouled with 13:36 left in the half. Foul number one on John Flowers.
When I was at UCLA as the head coach, we used to have Jerry come talk to our teams, as we did other people as well in the NBA and former UCLA players. And he was always a very engaging, inspiring presenter of information to young people. Of course, you could hear a pin drop when he spoke because of the respect that our players have for him. But always willing to share time.
Traveling with it. Let's go to Andy Katz. Andy?
Well, the West Virginia staff wanted Portland to put the basketball on the floor, make them drive to the hoop instead of just getting those open looks they got earlier in this tournament. That's what Nick Ravio did in scoring here. And Portland knows they've got to be better with the ball. They're not going to get open looks.
When you play a team like West Virginia, there's a very small margin for error, razor thin margin for error. So you have to take care of the basketball, limit those empty possessions, get a good look at the basket.
And Bryant got himself a very good look at the basket, but he missed the short jump shot. But another effort here for the Mountaineers. Another possession. Up top, West thought about firing up a three. Coming up on 13 minutes to go in the first half of this championship game, and an offensive foul. Deshaun Butler with number two. So that's an early story. Butler had a 26-point game against Loyola of Maryland earlier this season. Really took over the second half against Texas A&M. Scored 17 points in that contest. Some big threes. He has to sit now.
Robin Smilders back in for Portland.
Much to the chagrin of his head coach, Bob Huggins, who has been known to have an occasional conversation with an official.
A little low-key tonight.
He is.
Compared to Friday's fireworks along the sidelines by Coach Huggs.
But it's very early. Stoll finds Knutson. Nicely done underneath for Smelders, and he finds the rack.
Excellent pin and seal. Smelders with the finish. Precise pass there by Knutson.
Again, Portland looking very smooth early, particularly when they don't put it to the deck. Ebanks on the spin, the lead. Tipped up and in by Jones. Devin Jones at 10-9 against Long Beach State. An outstanding freshman season behind him, now a sophomore out of Mount Vernon, New York.
Well, Portland there, man or zone. We mentioned in the last game we broadcast, you've got to turn, find a body, check that body, and then go to the boards.
Taishi Ito, point guard from Japan, gives off Rivio to the baseline. A lot of traffic in there, but he draws the foul. Huggins in West Virginia thought it was mostly, if not all, ball.
Here he comes. Huggy's back. That's the Huggy we know. An earful. Well-devised offensive basketball as we watch Stoll take the ball over on the dribble here. looking into the post, freezer. Look at the seal, the pin and seal, the target hand by Schmelders. They're going to reverse the ball, freeze. They couldn't get it on that side. Once again, target hand holding off the defender, working the space off the baseline to create the vacuum or space or target to throw to, and the finish by Schmelders. Now, that was set up, of course, by the excellent pass of Knutson. So that's triangle basketball, working one side of the floor and playing off of what the defense gives you. They take something away, there's a counter, like a chess match, and you want to be able to read and react and execute under duress, which is what Portland did on that possession.
Bremeno has a lot of good passers. Schmelders is among those. The senior from Germany, who was honorable mention all-conference last year in West Coast Conference. So Riley will go to the line here. Had 24 points against Oregon last week, shooting two. And real smooth at that line.
You know, Dave, who better to have as a head coach of postmen than Eric Reveno? He's a big man himself. He studied under Pete Newell, the Hall of Fame coach, at all of his big man camps. He worked those camps, breaking down the intricacies, the subtleties, the footwork and fundamentals of post play. And you're seeing it pay dividends here in his head coaching career. So not only Tom Davis, Mike Montgomery, but Pete Newell as well, who unfortunately we lost a year ago and passed on, but one of the giants in the history of the game, a Hall of Famer.
Reveno learning from some of the best ever. Flowers into the game now for West Virginia, the number 8 ranked team in the country. Again, Portland has never defeated a top 10 team in the program's history. They've also never beaten a Big East opponent. That's a kick. They are 0-18 all time against the Big East. And 0-17 against opponents ranked in the top 10.
Well, this could be a breakthrough year for the Portland Pirates. Breaking the sound barrier. There's that trap again. High hands. Disrupting West Virginia's out-of-bounds plays.
Eubanks got out of it. Here's West to launch. Rebound comes out high for Bryant. And another second chance for the Mountaineers.
And to this point, that's been the one flaw in Portland's play, is giving up the second or third efforts. See the zone defense. They bump one another off. Communicate. Goes out on shooters.
Eubanks, not there. Rebounded by Jones on the weak side. Strong rebound. He's battling under there.
Well, and that's one of the inherent weaknesses of a zone defense, is you don't have the pinpointed responsibility or accountability of playing a particular man. You're guarding an area in a zone. And that's why it's incumbent on the players to turn, look, find an opponent in your area that you're guarding, put a body on him.
Niedermeyer. Too strong. Rebound comes off to Bryant. But how about the graphic we just showed you? West Virginia with 9 offensive rebounds. None for Portland. That one just tossed away. 12 North Carolina. You and I will be there in West Lafayette, Indiana for Purdue and Wake.
Well, the paint crew will be hitting on all cylinders. The student section of the Boilermakers.
And they are loud.
Gene Cady in the house. Mackey Arena. One of the great venues in college basketball.
Campbell bouncing inside and swatted away as Jones got up high for it. Joe Mazzulla now into the ball game, wearing number 21 for West Virginia. Swished from the corner by Kevin Jones as he buries a long one, and now West Virginia has taken the lead, and Jones is leading the charge.
Well, and West Virginia on a bit of a run. Now, if you're Portland, you know West Virginia's going to make runs. They've got a lot of firepower, athleticism. The key is not allowing them too many runs, and that's the way to respond to a run. Schmelders with the offensive rebound puts back in the garbage.
That was off an ill-advised shot by Ribio, but they got a little fortunate.
And you need that. If you're going to upset a team like West Virginia, you're going to have to catch some breaks as well, whether it's a key player on the opposing team getting in foul trouble, unexpected contributors from your own team.
Niedermeyer went down in the lane. Mitchell too strong, and now another fight for the rebound as Niedermeyer got tangled up with Flowers. And Niedermeyer commits his second foul. 22 left in the half lap.
Yeah, when you have an upset, key players on the opposing team getting in foul trouble, a bounce of the ball, an official's call, someone on your own team that steps up and unexpectedly contributes or produces more than expected. And then naturally your starters, your core, have to execute to near perfection. If you put all those elements together, you catch a team on a bit of a subpar performance. That's how an upset lines up.
Did you have a sense of it from the sideline that you were going to upset somebody?
You had a sense about your own team in terms of their level of concentration or focus.
Offensive foul.
Well, and again, that's the trap. Now, this is an example of a good game plan. We've seen the traps on both sides of the floor by Portland, but they're only trapping along the sidelines and the end line because those act as extra defenders. So when you double team, it's the equivalent of having four defenders over there in the coffin corner.
Cam Thurman with the foul for West Virginia. Portland leading by one under 9 minutes to go in the half of the championship game of the 76 Classic. Off the head fake, Sikma. Rivio dribbling to a freer spot. Can't drill it. He's cold early. Missoula up ahead. Ebanks pushing it. Thurman with a nice touch. Boy, that was a beautifully run break by the Mountaineers.
And one of the few times, Dave, that Portland didn't scramble back with that sense of urgency to protect the basket area. West Virginia, wisely opportunistic, takes advantage.
Ebanks does so many things. Running the floor. He can shoot from outside. A foul. A look again.
West Virginia fouls on two. Cam Thurman, his second personal, 17 fouls.
Cam Thurman just picked up his second foul.
Good execution in the break, sharing the ball.
So Smelders to the line.
Taishi Ito back in for Portland, replacing Nick Rivio.
Revan are really challenging this man to be more of a force in the paint this year. He's averaging 13 points and 5 rebounds already with half a dozen points. The officials are heading to the scorer's table right now. So we have an official timeout, and they're going to want to look at something on the monitor. Smelders forced to sit out his freshman year due to the NCAA deeming him ineligible because he played for a club team in Germany. And some of the players on that team were paid. He was not. He never accepted any money, but he was suspended a full season nonetheless by the NCAA.
See these coaches take advantage here. At least Coach Huggins has, of huddling his team up, getting a little extra time out. Take a look at Eric Revino.
Double checking the time on the clock. Mike Eggers, Jerry Pollard, and Winston Stith getting the championship tilts.
I think one of the real headlines of November in college basketball has been the West Coast Conference. Not just Gonzaga winning Maui and Portland here in the finals, the Anaheim Classic, but San Diego's
been terrific. Yeah.
Knocked off Oklahoma, Houston.
Shot clock down to 15. On High Jones, drilled it. Boy, he's a handful. He's 6'8". Who can handle him? Still trying to save it and throw it away. Missoula popped it up and caught it. Joe Missoula, one of the point guards, and he's wild with it, firing an errant pass out of bounds. We have a timeout. 7:52 to go in the first half. Pace picking up. West. The Mountaineers, number 8 in the country, vaulting into a 4-point lead over the emerging Portland Pilots. Part of Feast Week presented by Lowe's, the championship game of the 76 Classic.
Well, the traps for Portland have been good. They're in the deep corner, the coffin corner. Look at the hands straight up to the rafters, not reaching or lunging. And watch here as we freeze. Right here, these are the sideline and the baseline extra defenders, plus the trap, and the two players go straight up. Schmelders picks up the charge, draws the offensive foul, and you see the react there as he is fired up. Well, those are well-devised traps, something that Portland's brought to the table to keep West Virginia off balance. Just keep them thinking some.
You mentioned this a moment ago, the notable wins for the West Coast Conference to this point. Of course, Gonzaga has already won at Maui. They won the Maui Invitational. And among those victories, in overtime against Cincinnati in the championship game.
Impressive. I think West Coast Conference having a renaissance year. And if Portland was to win tonight, arguably the best week or 2 weeks of West Coast Conference basketball in the history of the league.
Sikma kept after it and banked it in after the miss by Stoll. West Virginia had been on a 10-2 run the last 3 minutes and 50 seconds.
We've seen this formula, mid-major programs out of mid-major conferences that get a group of 5 upperclassmen, 6 upperclassmen with good guards and capable big men. And that's a recipe for knocking off teams out of the power conferences that maybe aren't as experienced.
tough catch underneath and a foul as well. The bucket, and Jones is just driving them batty right now. Devin Jones still digging. He's hitting outside, he's hitting inside.
Well, good patience here, an interior passing, the extra pass in the heart of that pilot zone defense.
Fouled by Sigma, his first, so Jones to the line. For the make, he'll have 13 already. Team in averaging 11 points and 7 rebounds. He's having a night in the championship game.
Well, what I like about West Virginia is they're not going to settle for launching three-pointers against this Portland zone. They're showing the discipline, the judgment, and really looking as a point of emphasis for the interior first.
Rabio finding Campbell, who's been quiet so far after a 23-point game in the semifinal as he carved up Minnesota. Sigma turning. He's denied. Guess who's on him? It's Jones. Stoll with a leaner. Yes. Jared Stoll, 6'1 junior. He loves it outside that three-point arc. He's one of the best in the country. He's hitting 56% from three.
And Stoll did a nice job there getting West up in the air to free himself or get the good look at the basket.
So a timeout.
Stoll here with a little crossover dribble, the spin move, and then that little head and shoulders, pump fake, and then leans in, body control. But
also true of Andy Katz.
You tend to go on a couple frolics of your own.
Occasionally. Usually no witnesses. Butler over the top to Missoula. West Virginia with the ball.
At the outset of the broadcast, Dave, we said the keys for the Pirates to pull off an upset would be checking West Virginia on the boards. They have not done that.
Butler with a shot on target, a two-pointer.
We said limit turnovers. They have taken care of the basketball. And the third was they have to shoot it well from long distance. And they've yet to make a three-pointer. So they do have one of the three. But to pull off an upset, they're going to have to step it up in those other categories.
Well, now they're 0 for 6 as Stoll misses from three-point distance. They won't wait. Here's Butler again. When he starts cooking, you may need a timeout real fast if you're the Portland Pilots.
Well, that's what you want to limit, are those spurts or the flurries that a team like West Virginia can have on you because their speed and the number of weapons offensively they have on the court.
Butler, the All-American candidate, leading West Virginia in an 18-6 run. A quick look underneath. That won't fall. Stoll having no luck in close. Here's Butler again, draws the double team. Now West will set it up for Bob Huggins' team. Butler looking for someone to cut. The entry, Ebanks spins away from it. A feathery touch.
And good patience exhibited by West Virginia on that offensive possession. Really probing or investigating the looks into the pivot.
Biggest lead of the ball game. A 10-point advantage for the Mountaineers. Rivio finding the open man, Knutson, for the dunk.
Well, the penetration forced West Virginia to help uphill, which exposed the baseline. Excellent shovel pass by Rivio.
Cuts it to 8 with 4:39 to go in the half. West 28-20 West Virginia. Again, Portland without a three. They are 0 for 6. They were the number 2 three-point shooting team in America last year at 42%. They're hitting 48% the early going this year. That weapon, they don't have yet. Butler has had it, and he nails another one.
Well, here comes the run. Wouldn't be surprised if Eric Remno doesn't get a timeout.
8 for Deshaun Butler.
Coach Remno showing a lot of confidence in his team. Down 11. West Virginia feeling it.
Jumper from the corner won't fall for Niedermeyer. Ebanks on the baseline and an offensive foul, clearing out space. Devin Ebanks, that's his first foul. Deshaun Butler really starting to tickle the Ryan, thank you very much. We got a chance to see those final seconds of the Clemson-Butler game. A tremendous finish in that one. It's West Virginia Lab hitting the threes. West Virginia has hit five of them, and Portland's 0 for 7.
Well, Mountaineers capable of torching the Nets on their own as we see Smith with the catch and shoot. Excellent backspin. Jones from the deep corner and finished off by Butler, trailing in transition. Early offense from straight on the three ball, and West Virginia 5 of 13, the difference, while Portland 0 for 7. So that's what we talked about. The critical aspect for Portland to pull an upset was to check them on the boards, and if you look at that now, it's 18 to 7, plus 11 for West Virginia on the boards.
He banks off to West. 3:43 to go in the first half. Here's Butler once again, not this time, but a shove underneath, and the foul will go against West Virginia. And a personal on Kevin Jones, his second. So time to shoot here with 3:41 to go in half number one.
Wellington Smith back in the game for West Virginia.
Wellington Smith coming back on now for West Virginia. Jones, who's had a terrific first half, will head to the bench.
With so many players capable of contributing or carrying the West Virginia team for a stretch in a game, and that's why they're going to be such a tough outcome tournament time, and really a team that could go deep in this year's NCAAs.
Rivio hits the first. Last year, 23 wins. They went 10-8 in the Big East. Went to the NCAA tournament, losing to Dayton in the opening round. I think you're right, though. This version, with everyone now available, Mazzulla still bothered by a bad shoulder injury. Trying to make it back from that, he is playing. They could go a lot deeper in the NCAA tournament. 31-22. Jones with 13, Butler with 8 to lead their teams. Here's West. And an ugly looking shot. That is not said very often about someone with that last name, but he missed that one badly.
Well, West kind of double clutched that one. Little hesitation in his jump and release.
I thought you said you worked with him as a youth on that shot.
It's my fault. Blame it on me. Goes back to third grade.
I'm not going to blame his Hall of Fame dad. Butler will slam it down with a tomahawk.
Butler splitting defenders and poor help by the pilots from the weak side to rotate position.
He is going to get a lot of consideration for All-America honors if he continues to play like this. Came in averaging 16 points. Off the fake Campbell. That is off target as well. They're just not falling for TJ Campbell, the point guard who came in averaging 18 a game.
Here's the quick swing, the ball reversal. Butler puts it on the floor and takes an uncontested lane and dunk.
Lead at 11 for West Virginia, looking pretty comfortable here in the title game despite playing their fourth game in 6 days. They won a game against Long Beach State on Thanksgiving and then practiced later that afternoon. One spits free, and right now West Virginia's just a little bit tougher, aren't they? Wellington Smith tearing that one away.
Well, quicker to the ball, aggressive on the boards.
Another second effort, too. Ebanks running right into a wall, and he commits the foul. Devin Ebanks with a personal. That'll be his first. 33-22. The Mountaineers. Bob Huggins never seems happy when his team is clicking as they have throughout this 76 Classic. We've seen that scowl more than a smile.
He has a unique ability to crawl up into a player, breathe fire, give him an earful, and have that player respect it and appreciate it. And that's a fine line where the trust is there for that level of tough love. Not every coach can get away with that.
Ito off the fake, doesn't shoot it very often. He is the team captain. He'll fire it up and nail it, the three-pointer, and that's one the pilots really needed, finally. Be able to get there from three-point distance.
Well, anemic numbers offensively from long distance by the pilots.
Yeah, 1 for 9 outside that arc. In the paint, wide open, the leaner by Ebanks, and a quick strike by the Mountaineers.
A good delivery by Smith there against the double team, backing the ball up, bringing or dragging the two defenders with him, and then a good slash to the basket.
Campbell working on Butler at the foul line. Stole left open. That's usually his shot, but it's around and out. That's the way the night has gone so far for Portland. Bryant banks it in. Such a strong upper body, thus the nickname Truck. It suits him perfectly. 37-25. Stole. Can't bury those from outside that three-point line. That is not a good sign for the Pilots. Here's Smith. Flowers plucks the rebound. And West Virginia wants a timeout here with 38.8 seconds left. And Bob Huggins' team in command of the game at this point. Closing in on a championship banner of the 76 Classic. The long, long way to go tonight. Portland's a very dangerous team, but West Virginia looks like they are firing on all cylinders.
Well, some excellent execution here by West Virginia offensively in these past 10 minutes as they've made their great run. We see the transition, the drive, and the kiss off the glass.
Now, Truck Bryant can take a little bit of contact, can take considerable contact sometimes, and still get off a quality shot because he's so powerful in the upper body. And he's yet another Mountaineer who can step back and hit a three. They have a lot of those guys. Portland just 1 for 11 beyond the three-point line.
Dave, watch against the double team, the slash by Ebanks. Alert basketball to drag that dribble and the defenders with him farther from the basket area, and then the find to Ebanks for the easy deuce.
You and I watched their victory over Long Beach State. He did not play in that game. He did play in their second round game. They were a totally different team with him. Would you agree?
No question. Their margin for error is increased. It's another player that an opponent has to keep an eye on.
Oh, Mazzulla fouled as he heaves it back up there. Draws the contact, and he will shoot. Rivio picks up the foul, his first.
Well, the second, third opportunities.
Mitchell to the line here. He's the man who got fouled, Casey Mitchell.
Casey Mitchell at the line, shooting one.
So Mitchell shooting one to complete the three-point play. So 18 seconds left before halftime, and West Virginia with a 14-point lead. And Portland said they were not surprised to be here. They've been building to a moment like this. Campbell lofts it and misses. We've seen a lot of that from the Pilots. A chance for a heave now. Oh, it's going to be a turnover. As Ebanks turns it over. Their eighth turnover of the half.
Looked like Ebanks just split the defenders and was on top of the ball again. We've seen that unusual interpretation of the carrying call.
Ebanks 1.6 seconds, time for the Pilots. Knutson and Sikma among the bigs in there, and it's up and over Knutson.
Here's the carrying call, Dave. Unsure of this one as we see Ebanks is going to split the defenders. He's on top of the ball there, just throws it out in front, and the whistle comes right now. He's back on top of the ball there. So
Nick Rivio returns for Portland.
Rivio coming back on now for Portland. And Johnny West, three-point threat, back on now for the Mountaineers. Inbounds, return and fire by Mitchell. Almost got that one to go, but plenty did go down for Huggins and the Mountaineers. A very impressive first half against an outstanding Portland team. West Virginia looks like the top 10 team they are. They lead it at the break, 39-25 here in Anaheim. Right now, let's toss it.